So you probably already know that there are four different Finder views. You've got the icon view, list view, column view, cover flow view. But the icon view has some interesting features that aren't in any of the others that will help add some color and interest to a folder, maybe one you have to look at every day and you just don't want it to be boring. So how do you access these? You go to View and Show View Options, or Command J. And this brings up the view options for whatever folder you're looking at. So in this case, I have icon view for this folder and I have this set of options. Note that if I switch to, say, list view, the options change drastically. So you only see these options in icon view. Now the first one I want to show you is the icon size. So if you want to make the icons larger or smaller, you can drag this up or down. This is useful if you have a ton of stuff and you want to be able to see lots of things on the screen at once. You can make it small. If there's only a few items in there and you want the icons to be nice and big, you can make it very large. 64 is the default. You can also change grid spacing so you can move the items further apart from each other, which is nice. Also, you've got text size. So if you really need to be able to see the file names clearly and it's too small, you can increase the size. Or if you want to have them even tinier to fit more characters, you can do that as well. You can also change the label position. We're used to seeing the labels at the bottom underneath the icons, but you can actually switch them to be on the right side. And this just affects this folder itself. So it's nice just to be able to make a folder a little bit different. Now another option here you've got is Show Item Info. And you can notice here that I've got things like the number of items in folders, so 11 items in this folder, one item in this folder. I've got the dimensions of photos, so some nice info there. If you don't want to have these icons that are specially made up of the actual contents, like the photos themselves, you can turn that off and now you get these default icons here for this folder. You can also change the background. So default is white, to have a white background like that. But you can switch to color. Click on this color chip here. This brings up this little color wheel, or you can go to one of the other types of color selectors there and you can change the color for the entire background there. So you can really make this folder stand out. This also helps too if maybe the contents are something that you really want to pop out, like they're all images and you want them to pop out instead of having the white background there. You can also change it to a picture. So you can drag and drop an image. I'm going to drag and drop a file from the Finder there and have a picture as the background for the folder. Now you've got this Use as Defaults button here, and that will actually change these settings to be the default setting for other folders. So for instance, now I can dig down to this home folder here and notice the background is the same. I look in the samples folder here and you can see all my stuff is there. So I can get out of that by switching things back and then saying Use as Defaults again. And this one, notice I set this one specifically, so I have to actually change this one back manually, but other ones won't be set to that default anymore. So if you do like a different icon size or grid spacing or something like that, or you always want the label position to be on the right, you can have the Use as Defaults button to change it for everything. Now the desktop is actually just an icon view of the desktop folder, and thus you have similar view options. So I can do Command J for Show View Options, and you can see I have a subset of those. So I can actually change the icon size on the desktop. I can change the grid spacing, the text size, and it acts just like an extra folder. I can switch the label positions, show item info, take away the previews, and even sort here by one of these categories. So I can set it to snap to grid under sort by. So now things will actually snap to a grid if you like things to be very organized. So you've got a subset of the icon view options for the desktop as well.